Hello, Gundam fans, this is Brian92, and today I'll be looking at the 1-100 Master Grade Double Zeta Gundam version Kotoki. Now, this kit is something else. We're going to start small with the two core fighters they give you. So, they are identical, although mine, this one, the wings, I can't get them to lock in or out. This one, it does a pretty good job of locking, or at least it's a little tighter. Not a huge deal. But just the core fighter, very detailed. Got a little pilot inside with an opening cockpit. And you can flip the cockpit around for mobile suit mode. It'll flip up. Right now I have the landing gear. It'll roll, just clear. Basically like the Victory Gundam, or Victory 2. Just, it pegs into the back. And yeah, they look really good. Just as little core fighters. So nothing too fancy about them. So let's get the landing gear unpegged. Oh, and nice thrusters on the back. Yeah, they did a good job on just the core fighters themselves. So yeah, just the... It's two halves you put together at the back. And that's it. And this tail fin keeps flipping up, but yeah. There it is with the landing gear. Same thing here. Get it off. So, there with the landing gear. Now we can look at the bigger parts. First off, let's look at the bottom flyer. And cool thing is, they actually give you landing gear for both the top and the bottom. Here is just the kneecaps that fold out, and then the crotch plate. It actually it folds out, the blue part folds back and stops it from moving back, and then a little panel here basically like a skid. So it stays rather nicely on the table. I was surprised. And things lock together pretty nicely here. You got the stickers here for the sensors. And the backpack actually pegs into holes in the legs, in the back. Like, everything looks really nice and compact. And putting the core fighter in there, just gotta... Well, these are on a track, just fold them in. Push in the wings. And then, you just open up the little thing there. Slide it in. Like that. Close that down, and there you have it. That is the bottom flyer. Now, I feel that this should be more straight, but I can't really... I can do that. I guess it's okay. But, yeah, this is actually really cool. I really do like it. And of course you have the missile paws on the bottom. Look at that. God, that's so cool. You've got the thrusters, which the big ones are ball jointed, you can move around. These ones you can't, the little ones you can't, but yeah. I find these ones here, these wings, a little too easy to come out. They're not terrible, but sometimes they pop out. Of course, you got the beam cannons on the back. Yeah, pretty nice. And then we have the top flyer, which has another cockpit. Now, you can put a pilot in here, because it does open up. But the thing is, you have to take out one of the ones in here. They don't give you three. Which I think is kind of weird. Like, why don't I just go for another duplicate? Whatever. You do have more landing gear. Got one in here. And then you've also got ones... Weirdest friggin' place for landing gear. It's the stomach. The sides of the stomach flip out. And then the landing skids come down. Now, they're not that secure, but... Yeah, they're actual landing skids. So it will do the job, but they're easy to come out, like pop back in. You've also got an action base connector right there, which just goes into, plugs into this port. And then same thing with the bottom flyer. You can't really see it that well, it's actually right there. It basically slides down and locks in place. Like, those connectors are not going anywhere. Now, to plug in the core fighter into this one, It's basically like going into mobile suit mode. So, collapse the wings if they haven't already done it. Slide the thrusters in. This way you can flip the cockpit back. A little gray piece there. So you just flip it up. You'll see now he's upright. Bring that down. Tail fin goes like that, which is neat. And then you just plug it in. It doesn't really lock, but it doesn't really slide out either, so it's friction. And there we have the two. God, these are actually really, really cool. I am in love with just these. Like, they did a great job. They look good. I think they look really good. Wasn't really caring about these initially, but in this version, yeah, they look good. Now, to do the G Fortress, we're going to have to take the bottom one out. And then, you gotta do a little bit of transforming here. Basically, you gotta take the wings, bring them down, and fold the little wings back. Bring the cannons up a little, and then angle them down. You want them to be straight still. So basically, you want the round part to be up, straight, and the cannons to be straight. Alright, so that's pretty much it for that. And then here, you just have to... Well, basically, you just want the... these cannons are going to be down. Which means you can bring the skid down farther. And then, you're just going to slide the what's left of the core fighter into here, like it was before with the other one. So, see if I can show that, like that, and then this part will lock into that hole in the gray. Just gotta push it all the way. And there we go, and then you just gotta make sure the fins are, the red fins, little ones are behind the cannons. I'm pretty sure there's a better way to do it, but that's as good as I can get. And then you still utilize all the landing gear, so the ones on the knees, the one in the crotch, and the one in the nose cone. And now you have the G-Fortress. I can't get these to peg in all, like, tightly at the front. But this thing is pretty awesome. I'm very, very happy with this whole thing in terms of transformation and combination. It feels pretty solid. Here with the arms is a little finicky. They don't really lock. They're just there. But they're solid enough. And it's pretty big, too. I mean, here's the core fighter. So, yeah, it is a big, big vehicle. So, I guess there's nothing left to do but to combine... Or, I mean, not combine, transform. They're already combined. We can transform to mobile suit mode. First things first, we'll get rid of the nose cone. It just tabs into some ports. Actually, let me raise the camera first. Because this is going to get big. Giggity. So there's some ports in the gray, so I'm just going to unplug it. Like that. So just go into holes right here. And, oh, the V-fin's coming unpegged. It's a little annoying. But anyways, let's start with the bottom. Oh boy, I forgot these legs are different. Okay, first thing we're going to do is unpeg the backpack from the legs, which isn't hard. There we go. See, basically these plugs here go into holes, which are like the vents in the legs. And then you just close them up. And we can bring the wings back. Get the backpack out of the way for now. Separate the legs. They're actually pegged together. You just have to flip one of these. They all have pegs on both sides. Just flip one down, and it slides in the gaps right there. So, that's ready to go. Then, you can flip these panels out. Now, just going to rotate on the leg, so rotate it around, feed it through this, you see this track in here, you're going to feed it all the way through, and push the, you can at the same time push the thruster down, bring it up, and then it's basically going to lock where the gray is. Let's see if I can show that better here. Push up, and it kind of locks into place. And then, just gotta rotate the leg. Get the landing gear tucked down. You can fold these back. They're always gonna be angled down, but now they're like, getting them out just helps transform them. Pull this out. The side panels out. Get the foot out. Push it in. Flip out the heel spur. Like that. And you got a leg done. And it's a pretty sexy leg. Well, look at all the detail. God, this thing is beautiful. I really do love it. So, same thing here. Get that in there now. So I'm going to rotate it. Slide it through. Push the thruster in. Which pushes the foot out. Lock this in place by pushing it up. There we go. And then rotate. Around. Push these back up. Panel, 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 foot. Push in. Heel spur. Push everything back down. And you got the legs done. God, that is so easy. Like, it's a lot easier than I thought it would be. Now here, I'm just going to put the blue part up. That panel down. Skin down. That's done. Side skirts. Very easy. Flip them down. Right? These panels, just put the skids in if they haven't already gone in themselves. They're on a sliding track. They'll actually slide in and push in. They'll lock into place. So they're good to go. Gotta get up higher. Now, the shoulder parts, just rotate them. Actually, we'll do that after. We'll get them down. Because the head, the panel here, you do have to pull this out on a track. Then you can just make sure the V-fin's down. So you can clear it with the chest. And then there's a tab, which will go into the stomach. Two little pegs go into the holes in the stomach, so push that. Ooh, I knocked his V-fin off. Oops, that was getting loose. I kind of saw that coming. Oh well. Not a big deal. Just push that all the way in to the pegs, and there, get that up now. But over there, might as well just. Once you flip the V-fins up, you can push the red part in. It's actually got a little track. And that will keep the V-fin where it is. And slide the chest piece in. Peg the red into the gray there in the stomach. And then you put the neck back down. And torso's done. Shoulder rubber. The arms are cool too. So we'll get the panels out. The wings, make sure the blue's out, panel up here. It's not like a masterpiece transformer. Get those out, and then you just rotate the hand. Just rotate the hand. Rotate the hand. Come on. There we go. Okay. And another cool thing is these are perfect transformation hands. They're smaller, much like a Soul Chikoken. You just peg those into place, and arms done. Same thing here. Well, that was easier. Peg them into place, get the wings out, and then finally, gotta get that backpack. Now this part is a little floppy on mine. It usually is up and locks into place for mobile suit mode, or mobile armor mode. Bring it down for mobile suit mode. Bring the backpack up, you'll see this new peg coming out. I also have another piece in here. I'm just gonna peg that in like that. And then I guess we can keep those angled. And I think we are done. That is Double Zeta Gundam and his really gorgeous mobile suit mode. I like it. Oh, should these be the other way? I don't know, I like them better like that. I guess it doesn't really matter, but yeah. This thing is beautiful. Beautiful. I am in love with this mobile suit. It looks fantastic. That transformation was actually really easy compared to, like, oh, I don't know, the 99 high grade or 98 that came out. Yeah, this thing is, it's so easy and intuitive. Like, it makes a lot of sense how this thing works. And I love that they've actually given a lot of silver pieces throughout for detail. Like, you see, like, custom, like, the little emitter for the cannon parts here on the wings. You can see them in the vents. On the legs, you got little parts here, silver. On the feet. Like, it's just a beautiful, beautiful cat. Everything. So much detail. I love it. Now, I'm fairly certain there's going to be a full armor Gundam, because, or a full armor Double Zeta. But you got panels here that can flip out. And those panels I talked about that connect the legs together, well, they're on both sides, so that's going to be armor. The skirts have parts that can come out for connectors. Yeah, this thing's totally getting full armored. And then probably a FASB Bandai, which I'm fine with, because, I mean, this thing is so good. Now, you do have stickers, although I haven't actually used any. Which you have, well, the foil ones, anyways. I used, let's see, with the eyes. Actually, the eyes are interesting. They're actually individual pieces of stickers. Like you see, like a real grade. And they feed through the gray. Actually, it's more like a perfect grade, I guess. So I use those. But then you also have the big water slide sheet. And I'm not sure how long they're going to be doing this, but you have Bandai's doing premium decals. And they're freaking metallic. Look at that. This is just for the Double Zeta. Silver and metallic red. I don't know if I've ever seen metallic red decals. Like water slide, but they're beautiful. And I want to use them. So, those are awesome. Now, the final thing is to talk about the stability. This thing holds together like a champ. Like, it's amazing how well they made this thing go together. I was really scared it was going to be floppy. But no, I couldn't be happier with this thing. Like, it is put together perfectly. I don't think I could have done any better than they'd, like, at all. Both modes, like, all the modes work well. They go together well. They look good. And then the final result is perfect. So actually, I'm going to leave. Oh my god. I've been recording for 18 minutes. Okay, I'm going to stop here because I've been gushing about this thing. And the next part, I wasn't hoping I didn't do the next part, but we'll go through everything else because this thing deserves the time. It really does. So that's about it, and I'll see you in the next review.